The number one company, USAA, has just released a new program or product called the Safe Pilot. It's fairly new to the industry, and they're trying to keep up with all of the other telematics systems out there. So today we're going to dive in really deep to find out a couple answers. So number one, how well does it work? What are the restrictions? What do they require? And what are people's comments on whether it's a good or a tougher system to use? Is it going to cost you money in the end? We're going to dive right in. Any of you that has donated a cup of coffee, I appreciate it. I drank it all. It's gone and it's helping the channel grow. So if you guys want to donate to me, as far as coffee goes, it does go to coffee 99% of the time and it's great. Thank you to anyone who has donated. I do appreciate that. So State Auto is going into the telematics system. And if you are on this channel and you haven't subscribed, you need to subscribe, hit the bell icon on so you watch all the videos. We talk about a lot of insurance related questions and answers, how to get you guys to save money. Today, we're talking about the USAA system. We've reviewed tons of these. We've done the Progressive Snapshot, we've done the State Auto, Drive Safe and Save, we've done the Nationwide, the Safeco, a lot of them. And USAA, I can tell you right up front, is probably lacking as far as the tech piece goes in this one. So let's find out what it requires and what benefit you're gonna have out of this. Well, the great part is, the most appealing piece, is if you start with this program, you get 10% off up front in most states. There's like two or three states that I believe you get 5%. But it's a really cool program. I love the fact that they, no matter what, give you a discount. That's amazing. The second best piece is if you hit all of the marks, you drive good, you brake good, you do everything right, you can have up to 30% off. That being said, we're gonna asterisk this because very few, if anybody, is getting the 30% off, which you'll see at the end of the video when we go through the reviews. So one of the biggest things that sets this one apart from the other telematics is, like the Progressive one we went through, is it gives you a trial. Progressive does a trial, but they make you start from day one and they make you go through it and they start rating you right away. Where the USAA one is a 14-day free trial up front, where you get to do whatever you normally do. So if you think you have to drive good, you get to test the limits, see how touchy it is, see how quick it responds, and that's not rated against you in any which way or form. It does start kicking in on day 15, where it's now gonna track and actually give you your discount based on what you're driving from day 15 all the way to day 365. Well, that naturally gives away the thing that I don't like about it. I didn't find anywhere on their website when I dove in to how long this program works. So I started Googling some of that, and what I found was, compared to other companies, they don't show that you can ever turn it off. And that's something I'd like to know, if anyone has tested this, if they have a time frame, because from what I can tell, there is none. You have to keep this running on your phone at almost all times. Once it collects enough data, is what it says in its disclosures, then it will allow you to get the discount. And when it doesn't, then it's just gonna keep searching and let you drive more until it can officially give you the right discount. So it essentially lets you drive as much or little as you want, which kind of means that you probably can turn the app off when you know you're gonna be a little bit in a rougher time. You can turn your phone off, whatever the case is. And so it's not necessarily gonna track those sections of it, but it's going to start noticing that you haven't driven enough. And in most cases, I think you're gonna be fine. That's kind of its workaround to, if you know you're gonna be in a hurry to go somewhere. The other positive and negative is, the positive is that it does track if you're not the driver, although you'll see in the comments sometimes it doesn't. But that's common, that's what most companies are going to do. The huge negative that I've seen is, I've seen a lot of feedback where they said the hands-free counts against you. So if you're using any hands-free devices, it's actually showing that you're using the phone, and most companies don't track that because that's the safe way to drive, you're hands-free. Well, it counts as distracted. If a spouse is on the passenger seat with your phone, it's gonna count that against you sometimes. So you've got some touchy, glitchy type pieces that we probably should be a little bit aware of if we're going to try this app. Now, personally, it wouldn't stop me from actually looking into it because, as we mentioned or will be mentioning, there's a kind of a trial piece that it allows us to get a feel for whether we want to go forward with this. Eligibility, it was a little confusing, and the more I dove in, the better it got, because they did start off saying that everybody in the household has to be on it. And I was like, well, that kind of sucks, to be honest with you. But it actually doesn't. But it does suck, because when you have multiple people in the house, let's say you had three people in the house, they're giving a 5% discount or a 10% discount, but it's broken up across the number of drivers. So when people don't participate in it, you lose some of your discount. The other piece that I wasn't super thrilled about was the amount of data that they're collecting. So in a normal test drive system, like let's use State Farm's Drive Safe and Save, they typically only rate like three or four different things, and their really main focus is when you're driving, how fast you brake. They don't really care how fast you drive in most of them, and they're also checking to see like what times of the day you're going, where you're going, stuff like that, and the times you have heavy brakes. And that kind of determines what the rate is. Well, the USAA one adds some more pieces, but if you read their specific details in their disclosure, they say not limited to, which means that they can add more metrics in this on top of what they've already got. So the things that they're currently rating is speed, as fast as you go. So if you're driving 80 on the highway, that could affect it. Now, how much of a factor that plays, it doesn't say. It doesn't get into that depth and that detail. I'm sure in that 14-day trial, it wouldn't hurt for you to go a little bit faster, a little bit slower, just to see what the different play marks are and what marks it scores you for, just to test that out. It does acceleration, which is common. That's a normal one. How fast you take off. Also braking, how fast you stop. Swerving, so if you have to move out of the way if a deer comes along or something like that happens. I would assume, like most programs, that it has a little bit of a give, so if something is avoiding an accident, that's actually a benefit. So it won't necessarily affect your rate if it happens every so often, but the more you do it, the tougher it gets. That doesn't just stop at swerving, because they also included cornering, which isn't rare, but it's rare to see swerving and curving mixed in together, because they've separated those two categories. So now when you're turning into a corner, if you've got a shorter car to the ground, it's gonna naturally pick up that tighter turn, because that's just what those cars were made to do. You can take corners sharper. Well, if you do and you're going faster, it's gonna realize that, and you're not gonna get as high of a score as you'd like to have. Fairly rare of a tracking features, they do the distance driven. So if you're going from point A to point B, how far are you driving? So they're essentially mixing in, like Nationwide does, the Mileage Plus program, and they're saying, okay, well, if you get less miles driven, we're gonna help you out. That's kind of built into the app and tied in to be part of it. Not necessarily a low mileage discount, but it kind of is. Location, which is common, it's where you're going, when you're going there, how often you go there. They're looking to see if you're the type of person that drives to work, drives home, drives to work, drives home, drives to work, goes to the gas station, comes home, goes to the grocery store, comes home. So kind of boring is better in the insurance world, because they know that you're not often out at the times that there's claims and accidents and the most common risks where there's a lot of injuries. So they're going to track that piece. Where the asterisk came into play now, it's the eligibility section 5.1, the last paragraph. It says, and other related driving data, which doesn't go into detail. So I would really love to know, when I'm giving my information and I'm getting rated on it, what are the other data that you're taking, and are you counting against or for, so I have the best shot to go after that? I'm not necessarily too concerned about privacy, although you do say you don't share it, but like every other program, you internally share it, which yours is a little bit tougher, and we'll dive into that next. So I'm just gonna read the section. Data may be used for any purpose consistent with the terms of your USAA auto insurance policy. Data may also be used for other business purposes, including 1, understanding adherence to the terms. Okay. 2, working with third-party service providers to assist with research, analysis, and other services. So you said you don't use third-party vendors, but you do. I get why you use it, because most companies do this. If you go to any of them, they do talk about giving the data to like AAA every year, tells the government what the average, you know, number of drivers on the road is. And so it's good data for the government and people to know for news and whatnot. They're not gonna share your name or anything, but Once again, they also don't say that in USAA's. I would hope and assume that's the same, but that's what they're talking about there. Number three, detecting and preventing fraud. Nobody else talks about that that I've seen in the other ones. Good to have. I like that. Stop the people that are making my rate go higher, but that's a little bit invasive. Number four, detecting and analyzing collisions. So they're actually using the data in the event of a collision. Was he speeding? So in those states that you have partial fault, where if you were going too fast, you might be 10% at fault in an accident. Where if you didn't have the tracking system in, it doesn't necessarily depict exactly how they use that, but that's the way I took it. And so I personally wouldn't put it in my car in the shared fault states, or I wouldn't turn on the app in the shared fault states, because now I'm basically giving up partial fault. If I was driving 50 in a 45, I will get in those states a harsher penalty on my insurance, and I may even get a ticket. That's crazy. But I don't think they share it with the police, so that might not be part of it. So the end, developing and implementing new rating factors and scoring models. Most companies aren't talking about that. So they're essentially using your data. They're just not sharing it with companies that will advertise to you, which is kind of nice because other companies actually talk about that. They have internal sub companies that they use that they're gonna share with, where USA really doesn't show, or I don't think they even have that option. Finally, for the avoidance of doubt, data may be used and or discoverable in a lawsuit or a claims investigation. Not uncommon. I kind of actually would expect that. Although the wording that they use here, it scares me a little bit. It's a little bit too much for me personally to handle. I'm curious to know what you guys think. Am I overthinking this? Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are on this section. The second to last piece before we get into the reviews is the participation. So I was trying to find what these specific details were. Okay, so if we broke it up and I had three drivers and it was 5%, 5%, or whatever the case was, this is where I found in their section 5.5, their program discount, where they talk about the different deals and what it breaks up to. So essentially, if you had two drivers, it's normally a 10% discount. If one of them didn't participate, it knocks it down to 5. If you're in a state where it's 5% discount, it knocks it in half, goes down to 2.5% of a discount. So not really worth it in most cases. The 30% you're gonna hear in the reviews was not so amazing. People did not like that because they felt it was impossible to reach. But just for the sake of me being as accurate as possible, I'm going to read what they've got here. Upon enrollment, a participant discount will be applied to the auto policy in participating locations. If all drivers in the household do not choose to participate, the participation discount will be reduced and applied based on a proportion of the number of participants. I think they meant proration, but they put proportion. For example, if a maximum available participation discount is 5% and the household of two drivers only elects to have one driver participate, the participation discount will be reduced to 2.5%. Essentially what I just explained. Now, to compare this to other companies, like I said, the biggest thing is that you're gonna notice is that they don't have a cutoff date like most companies do, 90 days and then you're done. This one just shows every 365 days, so we can only assume that it's based on the renewal that this will continue to go forward and you always have to have it running in your vehicle. Although the discount is higher than most, I think it's Liberty Mutual does 30%, so and that's only 90 days. Geico does 25%, Nationwide does 40%. They go 6 months and then you're done. So the biggest thing is, even though they're giving better percentages, the better part is they cut it off after a certain time. State Farm goes up to 50% for some customers in unique situations. And USAA is 10% upfront, 30% performance discount. And then it's each policy renewal. You're always constantly having to fight to get that discount. So let's dive into the reviews and talk about what people like and don't like about this app. Essentially, it's a flop across the board. I apologize, USAA. You guys are amazing with service. You are a great company, but this is not the best program that I've seen so far. Let's go through a couple reviews. And what I found on Apple is that the average review out of 5 stars is a 1.9. And that's with 393 people reviewing this. And they really focus on some of the complaints is heavy braking. It says it's punished for stopping at a red light. People are stopping too quickly according to this program. So it's poorly designed app. They think it's too touchy. There's a few people that gave it some 5 stars and said not as bad as people say. Why is everybody complaining? Works as it should. So there's a few people that are doing well. The ones that are, I think one of them got a 20% discount. There are other people in here that are saying this is kind of a bait and switch. If you're going to join the company because you got in it for the discount, you get the 10% up front, and then it automatically starts saying that you're a bad driver. So there's a little bit of a negative in there. I don't think most people, and it's probably the agents may not be conveying it correctly, know that the first 14 days is a freebie. You get to try that out. And if you want to back out, you don't lose anything. There's no rate increase if you are a bad driver. However, you could back out of the system. If you do, you'll probably lose that 5 or 10% discount, the upfront deal that you got. So it'll feel like a rate increase, but it's not. As usual, this is a common complaint with most of the telematics systems. Braking is a safety issue where it wants you to brake slower and there's people behind you and it just creates confusion. Impossible to maintain 100. Echoing here, great idea, bad execution, not accurate. Great concept, but ... extremely flawed system. The discount, but the grading implementation is flawed. First of all, anytime you drive in the city with lots of traffic, there'll be harsh braking. It's unavoidable. It's not a driving style, but a necessary evil. So yes, I get that. So if you're in a big city, this is probably not the program that's gonna get you that big deal. Horribly frustrating, it's dysfunctional. Harsh braking while skiing with iPhone. Not worth added stress. Theory versus execution, phone usage, no option to say you're a passenger, although that does say that it does know that. Good app if you drive safe, much improved, doesn't work with Apple CarPlay, no hands-free, read the facts before using, which is what we went over. So there you have it. The overall feedback that I'm getting is this is not a great system yet. USAA will probably work on it to improve it, but based on all of the data that they want to use and the fact that I don't see where I can't shut it off at any point in time, but they don't also say you can't. So I personally on big trips would turn it off to stop it and block it from using my system so I don't have that trouble. But if I get in an accident, are they going to use that against me? I know they say no, but in the data, they say yes. So it's a little conflicting on what is really being rated for. Now the benefits of getting those discounts is you don't have any loss. So you're essentially not losing anything by trying it, but you're giving up a lot of data and you're possibly rated against things that are typically not seen in an accident. So if you have a plug-in device, which is kind of an old technology, which they don't offer, it doesn't know that you're touching your phone. It doesn't know any of that stuff that we commonly do. Either way, I want to hear what your guys' thoughts are. Let me know in the comments below if you've tried it, if you're going to try it, if this was a helpful review. Definitely hit the subscribe button and follow for more advice and tips like this. I've got plenty of other videos if you want to research some different ways to save money on insurance. I'm Mark with Think Insurance. I'll see you in the next one.